Hormonal adult acne typically forms on the lower part of your face. This includes the bottom of your cheeks and around your jawline, and it can affect all genders and ages, but especially more frequently in adult females. In this video, we will go over what causes hormonal acne as well as go through as many treatment options as we can. If you guys are new here, my channel is all about helping you make informed decisions about your health and wellness, and I'd love for you all to gently tap on the like button down below. And if you really like the content, then consider subscribing as well. Also, if you guys are on Instagram, you can follow me there too. Now, without wasting any more time, let's dive right in. So, hormonal acne develops when we get hormonal changes that increase the amount of oil your skin produces. When the oil interacts with the bacteria in the pores near where the hair follicles are, acne develops. The influxes of these hormones usually arrive from four things: menstruation, PCOS, menopause, and increased androgen levels. With menopause, it's gonna most likely be due to that drop in estrogen levels or an increase in androgen hormones like testosterone. Not to forget to mention that in adult female acne, there is an increase in the number and sensitivity of the receptors located in the sebocytes and the keratinocytes to circulating androgenic hormones. So this is why hormonal acne can be so vicious sometimes. But not to worry, since we'll go over what you can do. The first is to eliminate all those triggers that make it worse. Stress is one, pollution is another, especially if you live in a city that has high pollution and smog, high humidity, diet as well, especially if it consists of a ton of refined carbs and sugars. And lastly, squeezing and picking at the acne. Pustules, papules, cysts, you don't want to be picking at them. Secondly, if your hormonal acne is mild, you may be able to use topical retinoids. Retinoids are derived from vitamin A. Many of the retinoid creams, gels, and lotions are available over the counter. You may want to see your doctor about a prescription strength formulation if you've tried them in the past and they haven't helped. Adapalene is an over-the-counter third-generation retinoid that can decrease oil production. I made a video about it as well that you can watch up here. Basically, what it does is that it speeds up and regulates the shedding within your oil glands so bacteria don't have anything to feed off of to create the inflammation in the first place. It's kind of like being one step ahead of the game. But of course, you have to keep in mind that purging will occur. For some, the Adapalene purge can last anywhere from 16 to 18 weeks, but for some, it could be 4 to 8 weeks. Everyone's skin is so different, so keep that all into consideration. And comment below if you have any tips for it. Thirdly, if your hormonal acne is a little bit more moderate and stubborn and is affecting your quality of life, you could talk to your doctor to see if the benefits outweigh the risks for anti-androgen medicines like spironolactone. What it does is that it can prevent your body from producing more androgen and allow your hormone levels to stabilize. In the Adult Female Acne Guide study, the combined use of spironolactone with topical retinoid seems to provide a superior response to the retinoid treatment isolated in adult female acne. But do keep in mind that the side effects can cause breast enlargement and tenderness. The fourth tip, in addition to spironolactone, your doctor might also add birth control only after they can assess you would be a qualified candidate to take them together. The spironolactone blocks androgens from binding to receptors in the skin, while birth control pills can help regulate your hormones and decrease testosterone levels. The combo can bring noticeable changes after 3 cycles or about 3 months, and many will do fine afterwards with a clean and gentle skincare routine. So keep that in mind. And last tip is getting the Avaclear treatment, which can be used for cystic, inflammatory, and hormonal acne. And it can be a great option if you've exhausted all your others and are not actually a candidate for Accutane, or you just don't want to be on it. And this is especially true if you've been on doxycycline or other antibiotics and they haven't worked either. Or maybe they have worked, but after finishing them, the acne comes back. Well, with Avaclear, it's a laser acne treatment developed by Cutera that achieved FDA clearance on March of last year. Not sponsored by the brand or anything, but if it can safely and effectively deliver 1,726 nanometer beams of energy to the skin and can specifically target and suppress the sebaceous glands, the treatments can look very promising. And it's about 3 treatments total, and each of them take about 30 minutes or so. And you might be thinking that it's just a laser though. But with Avaclear, it's unique since it leaves the melanin alone and only hones in on the sebaceous glands. And the great part about it is that it's safe for all skin types and tones. And remember, in addition to any acne skincare treatment regimen, wash your face in the morning and in the evening, apply no more than a pea-sized amount of any acne product for the whole face. A big mistake I always see people make is applying too much, which can dry out your skin and increase irritation. Wear sunscreen every day, broad spectrum SPF 30 or more, and only use non-comedogenic products to reduce your risk of clogged pores. This is especially true in hormonal acne. You want to increase as many chances of success so that you can finally beat hormonal acne and get the skin you want. I'm curious to hear from you guys though. Have you struggled with hormonal acne? Do you have any tips that you want to share? Leave them down below. And in the meantime, click the subscribe button if you found any value in this video. And until then guys, I'll see you in the next one.